Hello, I'm Chris Williams from Read Comics They're Bad For You, the name of my YouTube channel. Or if you're watching this on BitChute, the name of my BitChute channel is Comic Freak. Today we're going to be talking about a bombshell. Does Disney protect pedophiles within the studio system? Here's a tweet from Tiffany Fitzhenry talking about former Disney star Bella Thorne, who was abused, she says, from 6 to 14 years old. This is only the beginning of this article, so let's dig on into it and see what Hollywood is really all about. The world recently learned that a former chairman of Disney Studio, Richard Cook, and a former president to Disney ABC Studios, Geraldine Laybourne, traveled with Jeffrey Epstein and Chasen Maxwell, both international sex traffickers, on a jet nicknamed the Lolita Express. According to the plane's flight logs, is that the real reason that Disney-owned ABC spiked their Jeffrey Epstein story? Are there really some stories that Tinseltown doesn't want told in order to protect their business model? Stories of underage kids being pilled with alcohol at the homes of famous celebrities, then sexually abused by adults, probably aren't stories anyone in Hollywood wants you to see or hear. Do executives at the Walt Disney Company knowingly allow some of their underage stars to be surrounded by pedophiles and even partake in child sex abuse? Disney is an evil corporation. Yes, they would use this for control and to use these people to make money. These are the allegations being made and thoroughly detailed and documented by Tammy Garcia, and she is telling a story that Hollywood definitely doesn't want the public to hear. Tammy is a mother whose young son, Ricky, became a Disney Channel star with a singing contract. She and her son allege that while he was under a contract with Disney, he was also being regularly sexually abused by Hollywood elite, including managers, talent agents, and executives employed by some of the biggest studios in the entertainment industry. I don't want to sound rude to Tammy here, but I don't trust anyone like this, especially someone who had her son work for Disney. How do I know that she is not just doing this to make money herself? But her son did suffer abuse, so I will give her that benefit of the doubt. Last September, the Ricky Garcia told The Hollywood Reporter, a series of Hollywood execs preyed on him, alleging the abuse began when he was 12 years old. Garcia and his two other musicians formed Fame in 2013 after he was eliminated from The X Factor. In a complaint submitted Tuesday to the L.A. County Superior Court, which has not yet been assigned to a judge, Garcia says his ex-manager, Chobe Hart, raped and sexually assaulted him dozens of times during his teenage years. Garcia also claims Hart groomed him into a sexual plaything that could be passed around his friends in the business, including ex-APA agent Tyler Grisham and manager-producer Niles Larson. He accuses Grisham of making sexually aggressive comments and licking his toes, and Larson of grabbing his penis over his pants at a concert in 2016. Tiffany Fitzhenry is a best-selling author, speaker, and public personality. She is also a Hollywood whistleblower, a prolific screenwriter, and an independent producer. She's been telling the truth behind the scandalous Hollywood headlines and asking the question, why does Hollywood even exist? Tiffany recently dropped a very detailed write-up on all of the salacious events that took place throughout Ricky's teenage years in Hollywood and dropped a lot of names. Hollywood doesn't want to talk about pedophilia, Tammy, Ricky's mom says. In reality, she quickly figured out the day after the story of Ricky's lawsuit broke and everything went radio silent. And of course it did. This story has the power to bring down giants. The problem is, it's the same giants who also own the media. That's when Tammy Garcia reached out to me instead. Over the course of nearly 2 months of phone conversations, as well as an in-person sit-down interview which will be released to the public, Tammy took me through a stunning timeline of events, as well as provided me with emails, written witness testimony, and documents compiled for the civil lawsuit, of all of which detail the years of torture and abuse her son suffered, the names of those who partook, those who knew, and those who covered it up. The following exposé is entirely drawn from these documents, emails, and witness testimonies. This is good, but it's taken years for any of the parents of the children who were abused to actually step up, mainly because I think they're all money-grubbing cowards, and they were paid off to not speak out. But one has, and that's good. During an overnight songwriting trip, which was strictly no parents allowed, Ricky and his bandmates were taken to Caroline Island by Joby Hart and several songwriters, all adults. Once there, the young teens were pilled with alcohol, including scotch, tequila, vodka, and champagne. Purchased and served by Joby and the other adults, Ricky and Emery both drank to excess to the point of being sick, after which Joby undressed and bathed Ricky, then Ricky blacked out. Ricky woke up the next morning naked in bed with Joby, having no memory of what had happened. This began a pattern that would go on multiple times per week for 4 years, steadily progressing to include all forms of sexual abuse, including rape as well as abuse by others in addition to Joby Hart. According to the documents, one of the first people in Hollywood to sexually assault rookie other than Joby Hart was Joby's good friend, then APA agent Tyler Grisham, who has since been fired by the APA and has a long list of underage male accusers. As these incidents continued, Tammy went on to detail an incident that happened at the home of Guardians of the Galaxy star Chris Pratt. Once again during the fall of 2016 when Joby Hart and Ricky attended yet another party, this time at the home of Annie Faris and her then-husband Chris Pratt, according to Tammy and Ricky's testimonies, as well as the lawsuit documents at the home of this powerful, famous Hollywood couple, Ricky was again served alcohol openly and excessively. Of course, a cast member of Guardians of the Galaxy would be brought up in a conversation in this article about pedophiles. Of course they would be. Isn't it amazing, folks, that these people keep getting involved in these Hollywood scandals? In fact, his director, James Gunn, gets included in this article as well. So what the hell else is new? Let's see how deep Chris Pratt can dig his own grave in this story. And at one point during the night, marketing and PR veteran Lisa DeCambo, the longtime right-hand man to Lance Bass of NSYNC and yet another good friend of Joby Hart's, took Ricky, a minor, into one of the bedrooms and sexually molested him after being granted permission to do so by Joby Hart. In what one could conclude amounts to nothing less than child sex trafficking, DeCambo was in her mid-30s at the time. Well, here's clear proof there are female pedophiles out there, no matter what the far left says, when you should always think and believe that women can't do any harm to children, like being sexual predators, or be as violent as men and kill them. Huh. Or abuse them, you know. And we're back to Chris Pratt. Many will recall how Chris Pratt, star of Disney's lucrative Guardians of the Galaxy franchise, came to the defense of director James Gunn after his thousands of truly confounding pedophile tweets surfaced. Yes, remember that story about how James Gunn made thousands of these jokes online and tweeted out thousands of these jokes, how it was all right to be a pedophile and how good it was to bang children? And how the cast of Guardians of the Galaxy just backed him up, even some of them saying they wouldn't be back if he didn't return for Guardians of the Galaxy 3? I'm sure you all do. The expose continues to document an incredible number of victims at the hands of these Hollywood executives, and the lengths to which the studios, particularly Walt Disney Studios, would go to protect the reputations, leading to Tiffany to ask, "Is Disney protecting pedophiles?" "Yes, they are. Disney is protecting pedophiles," Timmy asserts without it wavering. The article then asks that you read the entire thing, then consider canceling your Disney Plus subscription. Well, since I don't have it, I'm glad I probably will never get it now. Well, considering what I've just read, this makes me think that Ricky Gervais, the guy who made fun of Hollywood at the Golden Globes, he was right to roast them. In fact, Joaquin Phoenix as well basically made his comments about Hollywood. These people are so quick to jump on the bandwagon on Twitter and basically, well, attack anyone who disagrees with them. But the moment they actually get any criticism themselves, they'll tuck their tails between their legs and run away. The only reason I'm bringing this up now is the only time they actually stand by anyone is when they themselves are protecting themselves because they don't want to go to prison on pedophilia charges. This is the only time these people will stand together because they know if they crack, they know it would be over and their cushy lifestyles would be gone and they'd go to prison and they'd constantly be abused themselves. Well, that is something to look forward to once these people go up on charges, huh? This is why they're so keen to silence the internet, because they know with us being able to talk with each other, we'll constantly be proving that they are the pedophiles and monsters that we think they are. And they should know that we'll just keep digging, and one day we will make it so that they can't hide in the darkness anymore, and we will drag them into the light to face judgment once and for all. If you like this video, subscribe. Make sure you're still subscribed because YouTube is going around unsubscribing people, so make sure you're still subscribed. If you're watching my videos but you have not subscribed, please subscribe to me. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Read Comics, They're Bad For You, then go over to BitChute and subscribe to my BitChute channel, Comic Freak. Hit that bell for notifications, hit that like button, and leave some comments down below. And if you could you also please share this video? Share it on Twitter, share it on Reddit, and share it on Facebook. Share it anywhere you think it'll do the most good, because because YouTube is not going around promoting their own YouTube creators anymore, and it would really help me if you could please share this video. Now listen closely, it's plug-in time again. Keep checking back in all my future videos for more information on my own upcoming independent comic book Scum Dogs. I'm Chris Williams, and I'll be back again tomorrow with another video or review.